For lecture four review on water, basically all what you see here is going to be the answers for the quiz, except for the last one on metabolism. Now, the reason why I include that on this list is because in your book, it'll have it alongside all of these. But I saved that one for lecture five, mainly because it makes more sense with that. So everything from solvent down to acids and alkaline will be on here. Now, as far as the way the quiz questions will be phrased, solvent, adhesion, cohesion, surface tension, heat capacity, density, these will be the multiple choice answers in 8 out of the 10. Sometimes they'll be put together, like cohesion and adhesion will be put together because of how it works for drawing up water through the root system and vascular system of the trees, but generally they're going to be by themselves. From all the things we've talked about, make sure you know all the examples that we discussed regarding each of these concepts. Surface tension, make sure when I say liquid water, that's to help differentiate from density when I talk about ice or hard surfaces and whatnot for water. Again, most of the questions are pretty straightforward in terms of what they're referring to and what property, but sometimes people, I use the word surface when I'm talking about how ice is another surface that things can, you know, live on and hunt for food, like with polar bears and other things. And I say, what property of water is this? And people hear the word surface and they think surface tension. And so that's why I like to use the word solid for ice and liquid for surface tension, because surface tension only happens when water is in its liquid state. Now, the last two questions are a little different because they have to do with acids and bases, or acid and alkalinity. For this one, you have to make sure that you know the pH scale. Now, you don't have to know all these examples here, but you do need to know the scale, because I'm going to describe the concentration of hydrogen ions compared to hydroxide ions, and you will need to be able to tell me where it lies on the scale. Again, most of it is it an acid? Is it an alkaline? Is it neutral? So you got to just know this. And the reason for that is because later on, we use the pH scale when we're talking about certain parts of the cell and certain parts of the body. And so make sure you can define an acid and define a base, because that's going to show up. The other one is about buffers. Make sure you know the correct definition of a buffer. The problem that people most have with this one is that they think that a buffer changes the pH, when in reality it resists change in the pH. It keeps it where it's supposed to be by resisting any change in the pH scale to keep it at that, you know, to keep it at a 1, to keep it at a 7.4, to keep it. So that's what a buffer is. So make sure you don't confuse a buffer with something that neutralizes. Buffers don't neutralize an acid or an alkaline and turn it to pH 7. That's a wrong answer. Buffers basically maintain the pH where it's supposed to be, because that's what's needed for your stomach acid or for your blood or for your urine or whatever the case may be. Okay. So all the others are pretty straightforward. Make sure you know the examples that we talked about with heat capacity and cohesion and adhesion. These will sometimes be separate. Sometimes they'll be together, mainly just with this example on the tree. Know all of the things about a solvent in terms of what it can dissolve, as those come up as well on the quiz.